Jai Sri Krishna. Welcome you all to my channel Krishnavik. Today I am going to show you how do you install and configure FreeIPA client on your Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9 system. I have already described to you about the FreeIPA server installation and configuration in my previous tutorial video. If you haven't watched that, please watch that video first to better understand this topic. This open source FreeIPA is the Active Directory in Linux. I will show you in this tutorial how can you easily connect the FreeIPA domain through Linux clients. This is RHEL 9 installed system. Let's configure its network. Type nmtui command. Select Edit a connection and press Enter key. ENS160 is the Ethernet card of this system. Select Edit option and press Enter key. IPv4 configuration, choose Manual. Select Show option and press Enter key. As per my network configuration, I am filling it. In the place of DNS server, you have to type FreeIPA server's IP. And additionally, if you want, you can add your router's DNS for internet connectivity. In the place of search domains, type your FreeIPA server's IP. Done. Now select OK and press Enter key. Select Back and press Enter key. For network service registered, select Activate a connection. Press Enter key. Ethernet card has been selected. Select Deactivate and press Enter key twice to activate again. Now back and select Set System Hostname and press Enter key to edit the hostname. I have already set it at the time of OS installation, so no need to edit it in this case. Select OK and press Enter key. Again, press Enter key. Select Quit and press Enter key. Type hostname ctl command to check the hostname along with hostname and kernel version. Type the following command to check the IP address of the specific ENS160 Ethernet card. Now, view the resolve.conf file by cat command to check the DNS configuration. OK, all is well. Now we have to edit the etc host file to map host names to IP addresses. One for the IPA server and another for the IPA client itself. Save and exit. Now we have to install some packages, and for that we need yum, dnf and epl repositories. This system has already repositories configured. If you want to know how to configure those repositories on the Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9, check the links in the description of this video. Okay, now type the following command to install the IPA client packages. Complete. Now type the following command to configure IPA client with home directory privilege. Type here your domain name and press Enter key. Now type here your IPA server's name and press Enter key. Proceed with fixed values. Type Yes. Do you want to configure cronie? Type No. This is the IPA client configuration which we just configured. We want to configure these values. Type Yes. Type here the IPA administrative username, which is admin, and its password. Type KINIT admin. It will allow us to use IPA tools. Now type KList to check the ticket's expiry information. Type IPA user find command to view the details of all IPA users. At present, we have only admin user, which is the default administrator user. Type the following command to create a new user, Krishnavik, along with first name, last name, password, and email ID. IPA user Krishnavik is created successfully as per the configuration. The default login cell is bin.sh. We will change it to bin.bash for all new IPA users. Let's login to the Krishnavik user. Not query it for password because we are logged in from the root user. Type pwd command to check present working directory. This user has its own home directory. Now type exit to get back to the root account. Type the following command to install authconfig feature which will be required after changing the default cell. Complete. Now type the following command to change the default cell to bin bash. Done. Now type the following authconfig command to changes come into the effect. Okay. Now type IPA user find command again. The default login cell of an existing user has not changed automatically. You have to do it manually or simply can delete this user account and create it again. Type the following command to delete an IPA user account like Krishnavik. Now create the user account Krishnavik again. Look, this time it has bin bash as the default login cell as per our configuration. Okay, now type Firefox command to open the Firefox web browser. In the CLI mode, we were logged into the admin IPA user account. That's why when we switch to the web browser, directly got into the admin IPA user account. Log out the admin IPA user account. Log in the Krishnavik IPA user account. At the first time IPA user login, you have to change the current password. New password must have 8 characters. Click on Don't Save. This is the details of the IPA user Krishnavik. You can add or delete few settings here. Like telephone number, job title, etc. After editing the user setting, click on the Save button. Now click on the Active Users to exit from this user setting page. Close the web browser. Hope this video will be useful to you. Please like, share and subscribe this channel to boost us to make more knowledgeable tutorial videos. Thank you.